This is a technique for the lateral ankle sprain, and depending on which ligaments are more involved, we can fine-tune our technique to target those specific structures. So we have our anterior talofibular ligament anteriorly, which is under tension in plantar flexion inversion, and then we have our posterior talofibular, calcaneofibular, which are under tension more in dorsiflexion and inversion. So we need to adjust our position of dorsiflexion, plantar flexion as we apply the tape to target those specifically. We can also bring in a posterior force or posterior type glide, if you think of the Mulligan type techniques, if you find that beneficial. I think largely what we're doing is supporting these posterior structures. So we're going to bring the foot into plantar flexion and eversion as we cross the joint here posteriorly. Can do a little bit of an anchor and then posterior glide and come down to the top of the calcaneum posteriorly. Then we need to sweep around the inside of the heel to emerge on this lateral side once again so that we're pulling everything up into eversion. As we can come through the front, then we want to contact once again, cross the joint and contact that lateral malleolus, so we're always crossing the joint in that short position. So then we're going to continue around the tibia and fibula, and that just provides some compression and some force closure. Depending on whether we want to target more the anterior or posterior structures, we can continue this in different ways. Simple version is to come back into almost a figure eight, sweeping around, and then just coming straight up across that malleolus to finish up on to the lateral aspect of the lower leg. That's really targeting more that anterior talofibular ligament. We're in dorsiflexion eversion as we're doing that. If we want to target the posterior structures a little bit more, then we can actually continue this all the way around to maximize that force closure. And then we're going to go into that short position for those, which is plantar flexion eversion. Cross from malleolus to foot once again. And then just lock or finish off underneath the foot and cut our tape off in that position. So this band is going to stretch in dorsiflexion and inversion to provide more support for those posterior structures. If we go back to the first version, we'll finish up, finish through the side. We'll then come and lock over the top with the wide tape. This anchors everything down really well and just increases the force a little again. And this is for a late stage ankle sprain where they're not swelling and no longer bruised or anything. Early on, we wouldn't want to do this because we'd end up with a very swollen forefoot here. We'd do a different technique for that. So here we can start wrapping around, just covering everything and reinforcing that application. So here we'll just leave the foot in dorsiflexion, eversion, sweep around like a figure eight, come up. Wrap around once again. And then finish up once again through the side. Make sure you have a nice anchor point with no tension on the end again. There's a lot of tape crossing and overlapping, so it's very important to hold that very well to maximize your adhesion. We can see now that the right foot here is resting in full eversion. I can't actually push that heel any further out. You can see that the change in angles from the left side. What you'll also notice in the untaped foot is that when we move the foot, it's mainly the foot moving relative to the leg, whereas when we move this one, it's the whole hip moving. So there's a lot more resistance to them coming down and in, and then that recoil back, as well as we have triplanar compression, so mediolateral, AP, and superiorly approximating to augment that force closure and stabilize at that articular level, as well as decelerating them into that inverted position.